Hi guys, welcome back to the channel. So in today's video, we're looking and testing 7 spices and herbs from my pantry. This has been brought in by an article I've actually seen online where a European commissioner tested 1,850 different herbs and spices from UK supermarkets over the past, not past 3 years, but since 2019 to 2021, when they actually found out that a lot of the spices that we currently have in the supermarkets are actually contaminated, or not in fact what they're meant to be. So of course, guys, that's bringing me to the question, well, can we actually really trust anything what they sell us in a supermarket? The answer is absolutely not. So being me, guys, I decided to put the theory to test. So in fact, guys, this article covered 7 main herbs and spices that have been contaminated or actually been totally something else. And to some of you might be thinking, well, yes, okay, it's understandable if some things will be balked out. However, in certain instances, certain things are used there that could cause either allergic reaction, are carcinogenic or extremely toxic. So of course, guys, me being me, I had to put that to test, and I had to test those 7 herbs and spices. So guys, let's start with a first one. So first one on the list is actually saffron. As you probably know, it's one of the most expensive spices in the world, and it's in fact actually worth more than gold by weight. It takes 160,000 flowers to get 1 kilo of saffron. But in fact, how actually real is it? As we all know, they sell this in a tiny little boxes or tiny little pots in the supermarkets in UK. And well, I've actually paid attention and realized that in fact, they come in quite a different sizes. So to some of you who might not be aware, the saffrons get faked by actually using a corn silk. So you know the little corn on a cob and you got this little silk strings. Apparently they dye them, okay, to try to mimic the saffron. But the fact is, the dye they are using is actually something that is not even acceptable to use in a food. So brings down to a test, okay? The idea is apparently, guys, if you do have a saffron and if you want to test it, if you drop a saffron in a glass or a cup of water, if it's a real saffron, the color will generally start bleeding through very slowly. If you do have, in fact, fake saffron, then the color will literally bleed into the glass right away. And apparently, quite often, will leave you a white, not say translucent, but the little strand that's left behind is going to lose all the color because all of the chemicals and the colorings have washed off. So I have done my test, okay? I have dropped my saffron into the glass, okay, and it did take a little while, okay, that was one of the first thing I did whilst getting all this set up, and it was bleeding out really slowly, so it looks to me like this is a real saffron, because the colour of the stem is still the same, it's still orange, and it kind of looks quite natural. In my defence, it has been purchased in Dubai, so it is, says it's from Iran, which is one of the main producers. You've got Afghanistan and Iran, which are the two ones, the main ones that produce saffron. So if you do buy it in a supermarket, if you are intended to, make sure that it does come from either of those two places to maybe guarantee that it may be more authentic. But nonetheless, if you do this test, that should give you an idea. Apparently, it's not a 100% foolproof test, but it kind of gives you a rough indication that if something does react naturally, the chances are it's actually been color dyed. So next thing on the list, guys, and you would not believe it, and to be fair myself, I was really absolutely gobsmacked. It's actually oregano, or oregano if you in America. Believe this or not, the 50% of oregano tested from the supermarkets found to be contaminated with other products. They actually found insect particles, they found synthetic fibers, they found mixture of other undisclosed like leaves and plant particles. And how they apparently mask that, obviously they combine all of the nonsense together and then they use essential oil to give you that flavor and taste. So to me, as I said, guys, to me, I was absolutely gobsmacked. Oregano grows in, you know, really easily, even in UK, considering it is a hot loving herb. So it grows here, like in my garden, like a weed. So I don't buy it. I harvest it, I dry this, and then make my own mixture, like Italian seasoning. But if you find out that you are paying for synthetic fibers and some particles of, you know, insects in your oregano, it is absolutely disgusting. Bear in mind that the herbs in the supermarkets, guys, are not cheap. So next thing, guys, on the list is cinnamon. Again, it probably comes as no surprise. It is a little bit of a tricky one. Apparently, there are two types of cinnamon trees. The true cinnamon, okay, I'm not, I don't know the name or wouldn't pronounce the name of the species or the tree, but the true cinnamon is actually the inner bark of a tree that is dried out, okay? Apparently the cinnamon is currently out pretty much everywhere, okay? It's an outer bark of a similar tree, which is of the cinnamon tree family, but is not real cinnamon. And as I understand, they're pretty much saying that it's kind of so rare, the chances are the majority of us never actually tried a real cinnamon before. So the test you mean to be doing with the cinnamon, they say if you do buy a cinnamon sticks, that a real true cinnamon will be really, really thin and kind of folded really nicely like a cigar and easy snappable. The fake cinnamon, okay, it's quite chunky and thick. That will be sort of in the oval shape rather than folded like a cigar. Well, I found it a little bit difficult to test mine because mine is literally in 8 chunks like that. Although it does smell like cinnamon, but from the images here, it does look pretty thick. Not images, sorry, from the thing. It does snap well though, but it is thick, and from certain parts here, it does look like it is an outer part of a tree rather than inner part of a bark, because you do have those little ingrains kind of, you know what I mean, when you see on the bark of a tree outside, it's more rough than the inner part. So nonetheless, that was a little bit strange and a little bit unconclusive. But again, you might worry, well, it's got the same taste. That's absolutely fine. What to worry about? But apparently the bark of this tree got far more toxins that is actually the real cinnamon, and in a huge quantities. And for people that are sensitive to certain toxins, it could cause a real issue. So next thing, guys, is turmeric. Okay, you might be familiar with this very healthy, highly pigmented powder. Well, in fact, again, the research found that they use, a lot of manufacturers use a yellow chalk instead of cumin, or they dilute this with a yellow chalk. So in fact, what you think might be really healthy for you, in fact, it is not. And again, it's very shocking considering how expensive it is. So apparently to test, okay, for the content of your chalk in your herb, if you put equal amount of the powder in and then you put some vinegar, so if it does have chalk in there, you'll have a reaction and it will stop foaming. So luckily for me, okay, and this is separation, this is normal, hopefully you kind of get to see this, so the powder kind of drops to the bottom, vinegar stays on the top, but there's no chemical reaction. So thank God, it looks like my turmeric is a real thing. So next thing on the list, guys, it's actually cumin. In fact, they were talking about the cumin seeds. They're saying a lot of cumin seeds are, again, something else, in many cases also mixed with the peanut shells and other substances. Because of the seeds, they look very similar to even grass seeds. So it basically told us that a lot of the seeds there is literally mixture and very little of them are actually cumin. So I don't have cumin seeds to hand, but one of the things they did say to test, guys, is to have a little rub test. So if you do have a cumin seeds in there, because some of them actually also covered in ash, whether it's for the looks, for the color, I don't know. But if you do have seeds, put them in your hand, do a little bit of test. And if you have some powdery residue that has stayed behind, then means that it's something wrong with that and it's obviously got some coatings and some additives that should not be there. So next thing, guys, okay, again, it was a little bit of a surprise. It is a chili powder, right? Chilies grow abundantly, right? In many countries and in the UK, in the greenhouses, I had abundance of chilies, but obviously, believe this or not, they meddle with this one as well. So one of the first really scary parts is there, they actually found some red lead oxide, which is absolutely poisonous. Again, in a very small amounts. But the main thing with the chili powders is actually the fact they've been diluted with either potato starch or flour. So in fact, when you look at this, you know, 400 grams of chili powder, the chances are you could have like 100 grams of normal flour with a little bit of paint in it or some sort of other dye. Unfortunately, you cannot test for the presence of that, not in any known way so far. So unfortunately, if you do want to have a chili powder, I suggest you buy some chilies and then grind them into the powder yourself. So next thing, guys, and it's the last one, and then I give you the bonus one, is actually pepper. Black peppercorns, okay? Apparently, they found that a high percentage of the peppercorns, or pepper in fact, is actually diluted with the papaya seeds, okay? Papaya seeds, when they're dry, actually look very similar to pepper and have a very similar taste. However, papaya seeds have a lot of toxins, so you're not really allowed to consume any more than a very, very tiny amount. But apparently they found that, yes, a lot of manufacturers or a lot of samples they have tested found that the pepper has actually been diluted with the papaya seeds. So like, okay, I've bought a pepper, I always buy pepper in a whole, the whole peppercorns, and it was quite a reputable brand that does stuff wholesale that I've been buying this from. So, although it's difficult to test it, well, difficult to test it on the eye, however, it's actually very easy to test it with a water. Apparently papaya seeds and pepper seeds have, or peppercorns in fact, have a total different buoyancy. So the papaya seeds are likely to float, or will float, and the real peppercorns will sink to the ground. So there we are. Right, let's do this in front of you here. I have a selection, and yes, they do look slightly a bit different, I gotta say. They do look a bit different. So I've done this test earlier here, but hopefully you get to see this in the glass in here. I hope you do. So I'm gonna put a handful. Just pick a different one to make sure it's a good mixture, and we'll see what happens. Oh, floater. Floater. Yeah, look at that. So, give a second for the air bubbles to escape from the peppers, peppercorns. Here they are. Right, let's give it a shake a bit. So I have one here sitting for a bit, okay, and again, well, you'll see that in a minute anyway, they'll just sit here. So here we are, look, we've got half and half, half that are sunk, half are stuck on the top, and if you wonder, yes, one or two, when the air bubble around them escape, they will fall down, but this one's been sitting there for a while, and I still have the ones that are floating, and they totally do not intend to go down. So that to me indicates that our pepper is pretty much a 50-50 mixture of papaya seeds that are poisonous and peppercorns. So again, I'm like, okay, let's just, you know, let's push this further. So I have a real peppercorns, okay, they're the white peppercorns that I bought in Turkey, and as I understand, there's nothing really you can fake that with because of the color. And again, if I just put some of those in water, okay, so hopefully get to see that. Okay, apart from the one that just got the bubble, they go down like a lead balloon. They're literally just straight to the ground. Apart from one that's stuck with the air bubble in there. Here we go. So that's that. That kind of proves the point, doesn't it? So I must say, I'm extremely, extremely disappointed. Okay, because we're just talking about the peppercorns, right? The article also covered the fact that obviously the ground pepper as well, okay, again, it will be a mixture of papaya seeds, the peppercorns, ash, and the random stuff. Because when it's powdered, it's black powder, right? So once you get that a little bit of flavor of pepper, you wouldn't even question that. But the fact is that we're not even safe in half of the instances when we buy the real whole spices. That is, it is absolutely worrying. So guys, as a bonus thing, right? Again, talking about the seeds, I've talked about dill seeds. You know, they talked about the cumin seeds. I'm like, I don't have any, but I found the dill seeds I have. I have grown my own dill, okay? And yes, I do collect seeds. This was an example that I had, odd plant. I just put it in the bag. It was a utility just drying in the bag, right? Nonetheless, it just prompted me because I looked at the bag, but it just looks a bit dusty inside. I'm like, come on, dill, right? It's dill. It doesn't get dusty. Why would it be dust in there? I know, okay, a little bit of shells. Yeah, I understand, okay. So anyway, I took it in my hand, and I just sort of rubbed it in there. And do you know what, guys? When I smelt it, it actually didn't smell like dill at all. It smelt more like aniseed. So I'm like, okay, that's a bit weird. So guys, then I give it a taste. And again, I couldn't really taste much dill, but it's rock hard, like really, really hard. You know, and I know I cooked with it before. In fact, I made pickles with it. But I decided then to compare it to my own. And first of all, the seed shape is totally different. The color of the seed is totally different. And then of course, yes, you guessed it guys, the flavor of the real dill seed is totally different. When you bite into this, it's a bit softer and it kind of gives you that burst of the dill, like fresh dill flavor, which the dill seed from the shop didn't give me. It gave me more of aniseedy flavor. So I'm not saying it's not dill, okay? But the fact is that yes, it could sat there for a while in the process before it got packaged, I understand, but I somehow still don't expect to have a totally different flavor from it rather than dill. So if they're faking the all those seeds or certain seeds, there's also possibilities that things like that are also fake. Because if you have a look at the dill seeds, or if you have a look at the cumin seeds, they're all kind of similar. So chances are, right, that could be actually totally something else. So guys, there we are. I hate to be the bearer of the bad news. However, I think it's super important, especially guys, when we're talking about people with allergies and the potential things that they're adding on that could be nutshells that could cause a severe allergic reaction and potentially, unfortunately, have, you know, a fatal effect. I think it's absolutely disgusting. So I strongly advise you to have a rummage through your cupboard. I'm going to be getting all of my things out again, and I'm going to be now taking a serious look and actually trying to do a little bit more research for maybe other herbs and spices, because having a poisonous papaya seeds, yes, small amount, but I don't want it in my diet. I don't want to give it to my child. I don't want to give it to my husband. I just don't want it. And then certainly I don't want to have oregano is diluted with a bit of grass and a bit of something else. And in fact, actually remembering now, oregano as well contains some olive leaves that have been crushed. So there we are. So anyway, guys, yes, I'm going to stop talking now. I strongly suggest that you take this warning on board and please have a look through your cupboard. And the point of the moral of the story, where possible, try to buy a whole seeds, okay? But trying to get them from the reputable sources. But is that kind of indicator? It's not always possible, but just stay on the cautious side, okay? So anyway, guys, well, hope you enjoyed this video. Don't forget, thumbs up. Please subscribe if you haven't, and I shall see you on the next video. Bye-bye.